If you've ever spent hours on a video just to export it, upload it to YouTube, and look at it on your phone and realize it just looks like a piece of hot garbage, well, stick around because I've got something to show you. Shortly after deciding I was going to upgrade my monitors to these LG UltraFine 4K monitors, I decided I should probably also make sure that I'm looking at an accurate image, because when it comes to video editing, especially color grading, accuracy is everything, because some weird things can happen to your brain when you're staring at an image that doesn't reflect what the scopes are saying. But if you're looking at an accurate image and you can see that it looks good on a calibrated monitor, you can be sure that your video is gonna look good pretty much anywhere else. And so when I picked up these monitors, I also picked up this, the X-Rite i1 Display Pro Plus. And this thing is amazing. It's a color calibrator that you can use to calibrate your monitors, your printers, scanners, you know, whatever devices you have. And it is a total sanity saver. Now, the reason why I picked up the X-Rite i1 Display Pro Plus over the other X-Rite models or even the Spider Checker is for two reasons. One, I love X-Rite because they just know color. They made the X-Rite Color Checker Passport video that I did a review on a while back, the thing that I use for all of my videos. I absolutely love it. So that's reason number one. Reason number two is because there's actually some features with the i1 Display Pro Plus that you don't get with the other X-Rite models. For example, the gamma curve. We're gonna go over that in just a little bit, but the gamma curve is very important, and there's some very video-specific gamma curve options that you can do with this specific device. Now, the software that comes with the i1 Display Pro Plus, the i1 Profiler software, is super, super easy to use, but you don't actually have to use that software. There are some monitors, BenQ makes a few of them, that come with their own proprietary calibration software, and the i1 Display Pro Plus will work with most of those softwares. But I don't have any of those. I have an LG monitor. It didn't come with proprietary software. So for this video, we will be using the i1 Profiler. So let's actually just jump into the computer and take a look. We are here in the i1 Profiler software, and this is just the main screen, and there's just a few things to pay attention to here. First, just to make sure that your device is connected, you just want to make sure these first three boxes here are checked. It just means that it is ready to calibrate your monitors or your projector. This one isn't set up for scanners or any other thing. So you got your projector and you've got your monitors. The other thing up here, this is where you're going to choose what you're going to be calibrating. So we're gonna be doing the monitor. So we're gonna click display profiling, and then we're going to check the monitor that we're going to be calibrating. We're gonna do calibration on monitor one. For some reason that takes this out of full screen. So let's go ahead and maximize that again. Next thing we want to do is take a look at our white point, our luminance, and our gamma. Now, normally if you mouse over these, this help section will actually change and give you descriptions of each one of those settings and actually give you recommended settings based on your different use cases. Now, I have used this software before. I've actually used it about 4 times today trying to get this video done. But all of my settings are exactly how they should be. You can just follow the help guide and that'll help you determine where it should be. The tone response curve, though, I do want to point this out because you actually have a few different response curve options, like standard, custom, sRGB, and BT1886. Now, BT1886 is the official authorized gamma curve for HDTV, and you can only get that option with the i1 Display Pro Plus. So if you are doing video editing, this is the device that you should get because of that specific gamma curve. And then down here, we've got ambient light smart control. We're gonna turn that off, and then we're just gonna come down here and hit next. And there's not much to do on this screen here. We just make sure that our device is ready to be used. It is, and then all we have to do is make sure that automatic display control is off, and then make sure that adjust brightness, contrast, and RGB gains manually is checked on, and we just hit start measurement. And now the monitor is telling me that it is ready for me to put the device on, so I'm gonna go ahead and open it up. And you can see you've got your little sensor right there, and all you have to do is place this on the screen. So let's go ahead and do that now. And once the device is on the screen, it's just a matter of following some simple instructions. Like, they literally walk you through every step, which is absolutely amazing. So I'm just going to click OK here. This little box here is just telling you that you should tilt your screen so that the device is actually laying flat on your monitor. So I have done that. Let's go ahead and click OK. And then we're just gonna follow all these instructions. So please hang the device in the center of the display and press next. We've done that. Perform a factory reset on your display if possible. I did not do that. I'm not going to because I already calibrated this earlier. Choose the settings that are manually adjustable on your display. Now this should just fill in automatically. Like, I've got contrast and brightness available on my monitor, but I do not have RGB controls. So I'm just gonna go ahead and click next. And now what it's gonna do is some brightness testing. And at some point it's going to pop up and say that I need to adjust my brightness. And to do that, you would just go into your display controls and adjust the brightness from there. Now, those don't show up on the screen recorder. And if we come up here, you can see that we're actually pretty close to perfect here. Our target white luminance was 80 and our measured white luminance is 81. You can't really get any better than that. I mean, I suppose you could try and get exactly 80, but it's almost impossible to do. So we're just gonna go ahead and click next. And now the monitor is gonna cycle through a bunch of colors while the device and the software read those colors and make any necessary adjustments. So while we wait for that to happen, why don't you just head down below this video and click that like button and subscribe to the channel if you're not already. I'd really appreciate that. And then once it's done cycling through the colors, you just take the device off of the software or off of the monitor, close it back up, place it down on your desk, and you come up here and click next. You should get a little dialog box here that says measurement successfully completed. Click next to continue to the next step. We're gonna go ahead and click OK and come down here and click next. And now we wanna give our new profile a name. So we're gonna call this Display 1 Cal for calibration. You got that, right? You guys are smart. And then we're just gonna put the date. 2/5/21. And then we're gonna come down and click Save Profile. And I already did this earlier, so it's asking me if I wanna overwrite my last profile, which has the same exact name. We're just gonna click Yes. And now it's saying Profile Saved Successfully. Click OK to dismiss this dialog, then click Home button to continue. So we'll just go ahead and click OK. And now we can actually compare our new profile to our old profile. So if we go to before and after, you can see there's a slight change in the contrast, but other than that, we are good to go. Now, when I first got this monitor, it actually had a pretty nasty magenta shift that I didn't even see with my naked eye. So this software and this device really, really helped me out. But we've got our profile. We just have to verify that it's loaded onto the monitor. So let's go ahead and close out of the software. And we're gonna come down into our settings. We'll go into system. Make sure that display one is selected. We're gonna come down to color profile and we'll see display one cal 2/5/21. So our profile is loaded onto our monitor. So we're good to go. Again, the X-Rite i1 Display Pro Plus will be linked in the description if you want to check that out. I highly recommend picking one up. It's become an invaluable tool that I use for making my videos. If you want to see the other tools that I've been using lately, click here. And for more tools, tips, and tricks that'll make you a better video editor, make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit that bell so you don't miss anything. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.